Welcome to the NRL previews for round five of the 2024 season. I'm Renee Gartner and I'm joined by Josh Mansour to unpack all the games for this weekend and the second of our Friday clashes. Sees the Knights having to fight off a very confident Dragons outfit. Let's go to the home side first though in the Knights. Well, we spoke about it earlier in the year and it was about Coach Adam O'Brien saying that the side had been incapable of taking advantage of possession. It was quite frustrated about it. We saw that again against the Warriors. Jackson Hastings is back in number seven. Is he the man to steady the ship?
I always thought he was. He had an outstanding performance in the New South Wales Cup, 5 tries assists and put on 50 points for his side. So I always thought Jackson was the man up in Newcastle, but I feel like there's a bit of indecision making around the halves, like Tyson Gamble's or Jack Cogger, even in hooker position. You've got Jaden Brayley back in. There's a lot of question marks around the spine, and if you're having a lot of question marks around the spine, it's going to cause instability amongst the team.
Yeah, it makes it hard to sort of really find that groove as well too. So when you're talking about, you know, taking advantage of possession, you've got to know each other, like be lined up.
I agree, and I feel like, yeah, the halves have to take responsibility when they don't capitalise on good positions or on the field, but, you know, it's a team sport. Everyone's got to put their hand up, and I feel like not everyone in that team is playing to the best of their ability. So, big opportunity this week to get the win.
Yeah, and Adam O'Brien called him out on that as well too. Too many individual efforts and not enough team effort.
He's 100% right.
All right, well, let's look over to the Dragons. They're brimming with confidence after a solid win against Manly last weekend. Resilience was a key factor when it came to defensive efforts, especially on the outside backs. The same resolve is going to be needed when they come up against the Knights side, because this is a team with the Knights that they can strike.
Well, I think everyone backed against the Dragons last week, myself included, and you just don't know what they're going to come up with. Like, you know, that performance against Manly was second to none. You know, they were coming up against a very red-hot Manly side and they absolutely owned them across the park. Are they going to turn up with that same attitude against a lower team in the Newcastle Knights? No disrespect, but that's going to be the challenge. They are going up to Newcastle as well, so that's a challenge in itself. But can the Dragons do it? I feel like they can. They definitely got in them, got caused an upset like they did last week. I know Shane Flanagan is an expert at doing that, and I'm sure he's going to get them up for a big game against Newcastle.
Well, in an earlier preview, you spoke about there being giant killers. Can the Dragons and the Knights go to battle and they take down the Knights?
This could be anything. I feel like it could be end-to-end try-scoring opportunities left, right and centre. So I guess whoever can capitalise on those opportunities the best will win the game. The old cliche, right? But listen,
cliches are a thing for you. So
I know, right? But if I was going to pick a team, I would go to the Dragons. Again, I just don't feel Newcastle are cohesive enough. I still feel like there's a bit of holes in their game plan, but I'm liking the Dragons. They are playing tough football. The question remains if they can be consistent, but I like my chance with the Dragons.
All right, and it's a game of two halves.
Oh, yeah. Thanks for that one.
Yeah, no worries, thanks.
We'll use that for the next game.
All right, tickets for this one are selling fast, so if you do want to see this match live, head to nrl.com/tickets. If you can't get to the game, though, remember you can watch it on Channel 9, Foxtel, Sky New Zealand or KO. Kickoff is at 8 p.m.